Hi, my name is Ellie Sampson. I go to the Barlow School of Architecture, and this is my first project, Annex. The project was about a blanket which I put in my corridor to annex me and my flatmates to our flat and the social space. I started by looking at the interpretations of annex, so to bind, to join, connect, by looking at things like book bindings and zips. And I used a concertina sketchbook, which became quite important throughout my development, because everything joins and connects. So I then moved on to London. I started looking at spaces within London and spaces that I didn't know as well. I'm from North London. So I wanted to include spaces like from East London. I looked at Brick Lane. I also looked at places like Shad Thames, and I wanted to walk around and annex myself to those areas. I started doing some sketches of, again, more physical connections, so connections on bridges, how they are connected to each other. I then started looking at the Thames and how it annexes parts of London, not only north and south banks, but I also wanted to look at how little areas had been annexed to the river, so like the south bank, places around Millbank, and I did a walk along the river, crossing back and forth across the bridges, and I started at Pimlico and ended in the Millennium Bridge at St Paul's. And here are some sketches, things like on the South Bank, near Westminster, and then ending at St Paul's. Then I wanted to continue mapping my river walk, and I did it using thread. I took the map and sewed around the areas. I wanted to create like limpet areas that connect back and forth physically. And I also wanted to link back to my, I wanted to link back to the connections that I've made at the beginning. I wanted to make the project more personal, so I started looking at the corridor in my halls and how that is kind of metaphorically a river in the way that we cross back and forth across it, we're annexed to it, and how we use it throughout the day. This is a piece I did in my sketchbook again, and it folds out. I also wanted to start looking in my flatmates' rooms, and it became interesting to see how the ones I knew best, the ones that I socialised with, and kind of came out in the corridor space, I knew more about their rooms, they left their rooms open, and I wanted to explore that. Here is a plan of my corridor and how we socialise within the space or how different flatmates use the space. It was inspired by Sarah Wigglesworth's dining table and how everything moves around. It's interesting to see where we linger within the corridor, but also how people come straight in to the corridor space and leave it either into their rooms or the kitchen. Here I used fabric to sew into again and look at the spaces within the corridor, and it became interesting to see how the more photos and things I knew about each room became deeper pockets within the piece that you can see here, and therefore I knew the flatmate better. I also started to focus in on the space outside my room, Laura, my flatmate's room, and Tom's room. It seemed to be the space that we always hang around in. And I wanted to see how the corridor is an annex to our personal spaces, but also our rooms are annexed to the corridor. From then, I used a bed sheet in the middle of the corridor, as just as an experiment, between Tom and Laura's rooms, where I strung it to their doors and their door handles, and so that when they opened their doors, when I opened their doors, you could see how the canopy was created, and when they closed them, it fell to the floor. I also made a flip book of it to see. It kind of became the corridor ghost. This is where my project, I started to look at other ways I could show how the corridor is a social space and signify when people are welcome in each other's rooms, or when they're out in the corridor space, so basically when we feel sociable and when we feel like being left alone. I wanted to look at my flatmate Claudia casting her hand grip onto my door handle. So it would be as if she, when the hand grip was there, she was welcome to come in, and when it wasn't, then she was not. I started using alginate to cast the door handle. My first attempt, it obviously failed, because it didn't cast. This is my second attempt, where I tried it in a different shape cast and broke it up into pieces. And this is just another small experiment that I started to look at, where I create a bell that fixes to the door, that when you open it, it signifies when someone is in the corridor space and ready to be sociable. It kind of came from when we open our doors, we have a light sensor, and the light automatically comes on. So it's kind of like welcoming you into the corridor space. But I did prefer looking at the hand grip idea. I thought it was much more simple and cohesive and worked a bit better. So I looked at the grip that Claudia had made using plasticine and plaster, and I carved a cover for my door handle of her grip out of wood. For the final part of my fragment, or my set of fragments of this project, I was looking at a blanket which goes in the corridor space and kind of joins all of my flatmates together when we're sitting in the corridor. It kind of links back to my walk around the river and how the different areas cling to, like limpets to the banks. So this kind of became like the banks of our corridor. So this is the first blanket I created as a test. It was inspired a lot by Ernesto Neto and how he uses fabric. So this is me trying out the dialogue blanket. I then made another blanket which used old jeans I found in a charity shop, and I made my flatmate Claudia get in the jeans. She called it the monkey suit. And celebrate, it's a way of celebrating the corridor as a communal space, and so this is us all mucking around with the blanket. For my final blanket, I wanted it to be more about both flatmates, or as many flatmates as I could fit in the blanket. I didn't want it to be just one person. So I started to look at how you could fit at least four people within the blanket, and how we connect it to our rooms and the corridor. So this is some sketches and designs for the blanket. And this is my flatmate Tom and Laura using the blanket, and then all of us using it here. And I wanted to focus on the blanket as a choreographed piece, so where you put your hand, how the hands connect together, how a hand could connect to another space within the blanket, how the legs are connected, and things like that. This is some final drawings of my blanket in use. This is showing the choreography of the blanket. It starts with Tom and Laura. This is where I join, and I connect to both of them using these kind of tubing, plastic tubing, which fits in. Also, my flatmate Claudia comes out here. I didn't want to put hands in her bit because whenever she sits in the corridor, she's wrapped in a blanket and always just sits there with no arms. So I didn't want to put arms in her bit, so she's connected through tights. And there's this final flip book here, which is quite small, which shows how we use the blanket. The best bit about this project was that it was a lot of fun, and it was also the way I got to know my flatmates. They thought I was the weirdest person they'd ever met, but it was really great because it kind of broke the ice a bit, and it was a great way to kind of start my work at the Bartlett. I thought it was really fun and it was kind of interesting, and I learned a lot about how the Bartlett works, as how they don't necessarily need it to be just a building, a building, a building. It can be kind of, you can think about spaces in a different way. So my halls are really boring, my corridor is really boring, but I hope that this project kind of made it an interesting space and kind of celebrated that. Which really helped with my development because it all became. You need to stop! Fucking
you're
stop!
You're looking down again, there's no
yes,
point.
But I need to look down a bit to go and look!
No, because you're looking down while you're doing, like.
Issa, man, stop it! Like, you don't keep on pointing. I know I have to look up. You can't keep pointing, it's so distracting. I can do it, do it again! Oh, I can stop. Okay, sorry.